Hi, I'm Philip. In this Write with Cruise mini lesson, we're going to be learning about alphabetic cuneiform, sometimes also known as Ugaritic. If you want to follow along too, you're going to need this worksheet, which you can get from the Cruise Project website. Let's start by talking about cuneiform. Perhaps you've heard of it. This is one of the earliest forms of writing, invented by the Sumerians around 5,000 years ago. It's written by pressing a stylus into soft clay to make little triangle shapes. These triangles are what give the writing its name. Cuneiform just means wedge-shaped. But just like there's different kinds of writing you can do using a pen on paper, there's different kinds of ways cuneiform can work. In Sumerian, every sign stood for a whole word. So for example, this sign meant wood and was pronounced gish. Later on, cuneiform was adapted for writing the Akkadian language, and this is where things get complicated. In Akkadian cuneiform, every sign can stand for a whole word, just like in Sumerian, or it can stand for a syllable. Not just one syllable, mind you. Each sign can be read in lots of different ways. Oh, and did I mention, there are hundreds and hundreds of signs. It's all very complicated and extremely difficult to learn. But what if there was an easier kind of cuneiform, one that worked in the same way as our own alphabet, and only had about 30 signs? In fact, there is. It's called alphabetic cuneiform and it was invented in the Syrian city of Ugarit. Ugarit was an important trading city on the Mediterranean coast. It had close contacts with Egypt and Cyprus, and it was part of the Hittite Empire, whose capital was at Hattusha in what's now Turkey, and whose power stretched across much of the region. Ugarit had used the complicated Akkadian system of cuneiform for a long time, but around 1250 BC they started to do something different. They decided they wanted to write down their own language, and to do this, they adapted cuneiform into a new alphabetic system. So how does it work? The easiest way to get to grips with it is to have a go. The first thing we need to decide is what we want to write on. In Ugarit, they almost always wrote on clay. You can try writing on clay or on paper, depending on what you have around. Let's start off with paper first, because that'll be more familiar. We'll talk about how to write on clay at the end. The first thing you need to know about writing alphabetic cuneiform is that they don't deal with vowels the same way we do. They only have three, A, I, and U, and they only really write them at the beginning of words. It's actually a little bit more complicated than that, but this will do for now. This means you need to leave out any vowels in the word you want to write unless they come at the very start. As an example, let's try writing a name. How about Ilimilku? This is the name of one of the most famous scribes at Ugarit. His name starts with I, but we need to leave out all the other vowels. So the letters we're looking for are I, L, M, L, K. Have a look at this table, or the worksheet, and see which signs you need to write down these sounds. All you need to do is copy them down. Just like our alphabet, Ugaritic is written left to right, at least most of the time. That's pretty much all there is to it. The only other thing you might notice which is strange is that Ugaritic has several letters which we don't have in English. For example, they have three different H's, several different S's, and even a letter that stands for sh. It's okay if you're not sure which of these to use. The worksheet tries to explain the differences between them, but they can be quite difficult to hear if you're not used to them. Try to hear the difference between the three H's. H. 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 For most English names, you'll want this H and this S. But if your name comes from another language, just pick the one that you think sounds closest. Okay, so we know the principles of writing alphabetic cuneiform now. How do we go about writing it in clay? This can be quite challenging because you have to think about two things at once. First, what sign you need to write, and second, how to actually make it in the clay. It might help to write down your word on paper first. You're going to need a piece of modelling clay or plasticine, and a stylus with a rectangular end to make the sign. The wrong end of a chopstick works well. You make all the little triangles by pressing this into the clay at different angles. Just make sure that you press the edge in first, otherwise your triangles will come out as rectangles. Don't be surprised if you need a bit of practice before you get the hang of it. Everybody does. Even the trained scribes in Ugarit needed to practice before they could write these signs reliably. We know because we found a lot of their schoolwork. Once you've worked out how to make wedges pointing in different directions, why don't you try writing out the whole alphabet? This is also something scribes did in Ugarit when they were learning how to write. Once you've got the hang of writing letters on their own, you can try putting them together to write your word or name. With a bit of practice, you can write just like an ancient Ugaritian scribe. Here's a tablet I made just using modelling clay and a chopstick. It's pretty small, but it's still twice as big as the ancient one it's based on. Cuneiform could be really tiny. You don't need to write that small yet, though. I hope you've enjoyed learning about alphabetic cuneiform. Remember, you can get the worksheets from the Cruise Project website, and we'll be back soon to look at another ancient writing system.